And good afternoon to you, boys and girls. It's Sunday, the 12th of February, 2017. Welcome along to today's United Kingdom Talk. I was just looking at the... I've swapped browsers at the moment, and I'll tell you why. When I'm doing the show, I've been on Chrome for quite some time now, and I've noticed I have like several tabs open, you know, with different pages, or mainly news stories and emails and things like that waiting to be read out. I've noticed the more tabs I open in the Chrome, the slower that the computer becomes. And you know, at the top of the tab, there's a little thing that goes round and round, and then it stops, which means everything's loaded. Well, in Chrome, I noticed once you've got like four or five open, this little thing keeps going round and doesn't stop. And then you click on another tab to get another page up, and it takes forever to load up. So I've actually gone back to, I don't think it's called Explorer. Is it still called Explorer? The Microsoft one. Anyway, I've gone back to that today, and I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I've got 7 pages open at the top there, and there's no little thing going around, so I presume that it's all loaded in all right there. But, when you're watching that countdown, I can't hear it unless I open up another web page on that browser. That's the issue with forgetting to push the button, which I've now pushed. Thank you, Gustav, just before you tell me that, all right? And I was playing the music through the Explorer browser, and it kept speeding up and slowing down. How strange and mysterious is that? So I don't know why that is. Very, very odd. And then I opened just that page in Chrome, and it sounded fine. So very, very strange and mysterious. Good morning, everyone. Good afternoon, rather. Welcome to the show. Let's say hello to the early people who are with us today. Oh, which I haven't got up. Just a minute. There we are. Early people, where are you? There we go. 1 minute. Get those names up. People get ever so upset if you don't read their names out. Oh, yes. They go mad. Joanna is very upset at the moment with me because I missed one of her messages. She's gone mad, dear. Oh, because she's in hospital at the moment. She started throwing bedpans all around and, you know, and threatening nurses with needles. She'd pick up a hypodermic needle that was sitting in a little tray next to her in the bed. And this nurse came in, everything all right, Joanna? And she's shot up out of the bed with this needle like this. You get that Chris Reardon on the phone and tell me he hasn't read out my messages from Friday's show. Oh, she goes, people get ever so upset, dear. There's someone very, very upset in the news this morning, and it is hilarious. I've got to start off with this story, actually. Before I even read, Oh, hang on a minute. Where is it now? Oh, what? Just a minute. It's gone now. I'm sure. There it is. I've got it. This is hilarious. This is hilarious. Now, you've got to be not politically correct to understand the joke. You ready? And then I'll read out your names. You ready? I love this. In the news this morning, David Davis. Now, he's a member of Parliament. Now, which party? He looks like a Conservative, actually. Hang on a minute. Because they've got that look, haven't they? Kind of smart, short hair, always wearing blue jackets. All right, you can tell them. David Davis. Is he a Conservative? Yes, he is. OK, David Davis, this isn't... Now, we've gone highbrow today. We've gone very highbrow. Usually, I'll read you out a story or two from the Daily Mail, or even the Sun, or even the Daily Express. This morning, the Telegraph. Oh, God, I'm practically BBC today. Possibly not as left-wing as them, but I'm practically the BBC today. We're reading something from the Telegraph, can you believe, dear? Anyway, it says, David Davis in sexist storm. After denying he'd tried to kiss Diane Abbott following a Brexit vote. God knows how anyone can try and kiss Diane Abbott with that mouth of hers. I mean, she wouldn't keep it still for long enough, would she? And then they're moaning and moaning and moaning all the time. I can't bear people that just spend their entire life moaning. I can't. Anyway, let's have a look. David Davis has found himself at the... This is in this morning's Daily Telegraph. Sunday Telegraph, even. I can't read that, but it's just too big, isn't it? You know those great... Now, I've got... This is the size of a newspaper you want, okay? That's how big a newspaper should be. You get the Telegraph, and it's like this, isn't it? It's you know, it's like that, and it's Hang on a minute, one minute. It's like twice the size of it, widthways and up and down. And you're just on this, and for blooming things go flying all over the place. I can't read those, what are they called? Broadsheets, that's it, broadsheets. Back to the story. David Davis has found himself at the centre of a sexism rail after claiming he would never have tried to kiss Diane Abbott because he's not blind. Now, I find it hilarious. It could have been Diane Abbott. It could have been Gloria Hunniford. It could have been me. It's just a funny thing to say. Oh, no, but they haven't seen it like that, have they? He's making a joke. Are you people stupid or what? God's sake, the Brexit secretary reportedly tried to embrace... what, with tongues? Oh, no, old people kissing. Oh, no. Oh, hang on a minute, I'm 54. There was... years ago, about 6 years ago, there was a picture of me kissing someone, a bit younger, not much younger, about 15 years younger, and they put it on my Facebook, unbeknownst, I never put it on there, this bloke put it on the Facebook of me, so he was about 30, and I was 45, and there was a picture of me kissing, you know, and they put it on my, well, my sister went mad, and we don't want to see that story. Old people kissing. Oh, no. No, we don't want to see that, do we? Anyway, the Brexit secretary tried to embrace the shadow Home Secretary in a Commons bar last week after MPs voted overwhelmingly to trigger Article 50. But that's nothing to do with that. This is nothing to do with that. It was reported that the delectable Mrs. Abbott, who's not bad looking, actually, she's all right. She's just got a bit of a mouth on her. That's her trouble. It was reported that Mrs. Abbott told Mr. Davis to F off. Can you just imagine? You can see it, can't you? In this Commons bar. And rejected his advances. After the incident, Mr. Davis exchanged text messages with another Tory MP regarding the incident, according to the Mail on Sunday. The newspaper reported that the friend texted Mr. Davis saying, "Cannot believe you made an attempt to give DA a hug." The cabinet minister replied, "Didn't, but the myth grows. I whispered in her ear, 'Thank you for the vote,' hence the F off. I'm not blind." It just keeps going, doesn't it? The colleague then wrote, "Ha ha, thank God you aren't blind. Great week for you in Brexit." Then, in an apparent reference to the Specsavers advert, in which people with bad eyesight make embarrassing mistakes, Mr. Davis texts, "Actually, it would make a good Optical Express advert. Yes, a reasonable success." Oh, dear. And here we go. Jess Phillips, a Labour MP, said, "You'd have hoped this sort of misogynistic sexist attitude had gone out in the 1950s. You stupid cow! It's a joke, dear! Why can't you get a joke? You really are thick! I've decided that most politically correct people are actually not sensitive. They are thick because they don't get the joke. It's a joke." And here we are, Chucka Amuna MP, told Sky's Sophie... Oh, Sky Television. Chucka Amuna told Sky's Sophie Ridge... Now, who's she? Is that a newsreader on there? I'm not keen on Sky. "I think it's sexist. I think it's misogynistic. It's appalling." No, it's not. It's a joke, Chucka. Can't you get... And if you can't get a joke, you certainly shouldn't be working in the government, dear. Can't you get a joke? David Davis, here's a member of the cabinet. This is a member of the cabinet. What does that say about the party to your country? It says that they've got a sense of humour, Thicko. They've got a sense of humour. How can you even say that? So there we are. I had to read you that story this morning because I've been howling watching this unfold now. Of course, so it doesn't go away. All the papers and everything out, and they'll jump on top of it until the next thing comes along. And then they'll be on top of that. You know, but old people kissing, I don't know. I mean, is that something we want to see? I mean, if I was to come here live on the show and give a good old kiss to maybe Jeremy Corbyn, you know, if Jeremy come in here, you know, because I mean, he's Labour, isn't he? You know, supposed to accept everyone. supposed to accept everyone. So, you know, if he came in here and I went for, oh, now how would you feel about that? Or would he turn around and say, I'm blind, not desperate to me? What do you think? There we are. I just had to read you out that this morning. Right, let's say hello to our early morning people this morning. Good morning to Jerry. Jerry's with us this morning. Adam's there. Adam the plumber. Good morning, Adam. Gustav says, give your knob a twiddle. My knob has been twiddled and is now ready to accept phone calls. It is my little knob there, okay? Good morning to Sean Riches. Were you DJing last night, Sean? Chris Reardon's there. Oh, that's me. That's there. Elaine. Good morning to Elaine, who loves the opening music. Do you like all that? It's very nice, isn't it? The second part of the music, you know, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, that is written by David Arnold, who also wrote, he's done a lot. He's wrote scores for James Bond, millions of radio jingles. He's just so much work. And I heard this music 30 years ago and I thought I'd love to use that for my show. And I wrote and asked him, you know, how much would it cost? And he gave me permission to use it for free. How kind of an actual email from the man himself. That's almost, not quite as, almost as good as receiving a personal letter from the great Barry Manilow. Looks like we made it. Barry Manilow concert coming up soon in New York. Are you going? Oh, I say, I must say, though, those top buy price tickets are a little bit pricey this time, aren't they? Ooh, somebody's getting greedy. It won't be Barry. Won't be Barry. He doesn't need money. Someone's getting greedy. It must be the promoter. My word, the platinum experience is like $2,000 now. I don't think so. I don't think we'd be paying for that. And I've been thinking about that. Oh, there's, what was the other thing about, now what paper did I see this in this morning? I'm going to have to be very, Daily Mail possibly. Just a minute, there's something I remembered that I saw last night that I wanted to read you. Daily Mail, Rent a Star's Bed or something like that. Let me see if I can find that. I bet I can't. No, I'm not going to find that, am I? I'll have to go. I'll probably have to go right through the blooming Daily Mail front page to find that. Let's just do it quickly for you. I've got to read you this because I've got an offer here you can't refuse. If I can find it, that is. Quickly now. No, I can't. Oh, there's another funny story there. No, I can't find it. Basically, it was stars that you can rent out. Oh, now, who's the bloke in the Titanic? What's his name? Rent a Star's Bed or something like that, was it? Oh, God. Rent a Star's Bed. Try that. Rent a Star's Bed? No. I'm not going to find that again, am I? I might save that for another show then, if I remember. Okay. I'll try. I might find it later on. Good morning to Shania, who says, broadcasting when we are live on Vectis Radio. Absolutely shocking. Oh, I'm sorry, Shania. Perhaps we could do a live link up here. You could call in and we could do both shows at the same time. Wouldn't that be exciting? That'd be nice, Shania. Shania's on air this morning, this afternoon, with her dad, Humphrey, at Vectis Radio on Isley Widget, also known as the Isle of Wight. Good morning to Terry Turner, who's with us this afternoon. Elaine, okay, why is that flashing? Elaine says, happy Sunday, everyone, and a happy Sunday to you as well, Elaine. She says, have you heard the new Barry Manilow single? I have, and I love it very much. Thank you very much, Elaine. I'm really enjoying that. And I'm enjoying your show as well. I've got about 20 minutes through so far. A couple of little errors there where the wrong song comes on, innit? But it doesn't matter. It's your first show, my love. Fantastic. Who's on the line, please, calling in?
It's Humpty. I want a word with you.
A very good morning to you. Humpty Dumpty, how are you today?
How dare you broadcast at the same time as me?
Well, I don't know that you're on, do I?
Well, I didn't know that you were on until I found out on Facebook. But now we clashed here. It's like wearing red and purple together. We're clashing.
Is this a simultaneous transmission? Is it a simultaneous transmission, lovey?
It can be in a minute. If you've got about a minute to hang about and I press the right button.
Oh, are we going to be on together?
They're talking to me privately at the moment. I've got some music running, but...
Oh, okay.
I best not pipe music through to you, otherwise I'll get you into all sorts of copyright problems, but...
Okay, that's all right, yes. I'll wait for you. I'll let you lead as it's your show, okay?
Yes, it's all right.
I'll chat
away from it. And hopefully, if I do all the technical things right, which it probably won't happen...
How exciting! Am I going to be on the wireless on the Isle of Wight? Oh, my God. My career is peaking today. It is peaking so high, it really is.
I know.
How long have we got to go?
We've got 36 seconds.
36 seconds. Stand by, studio. 36 seconds. Quiet in the studio, please. 36 seconds. Stand by. 30 seconds, studio. Get the bloody light on. Where's the light?
You're going to not hear from me for 20 seconds, and we'll be live, okay?
Oh, 20 seconds. Are you going to count down?
Hang on a minute.
Oh, okay.
Does it matter if I give you 10 seconds of music? Would you prefer I don't?
No, don't.
Okay.
You never know. The copyright people listen.
Right, a couple of seconds, I'll be with you. Then that was the Communards with Never Can Say Goodbye. If I put this fader up here now. All right. Hello, are you there, Mr. Reardon?
Ah, good evening. Yeah, you've got a little bit of an echo on there. Can you do anything about that or not? echo.
Is there still an echo?
No, it's gone now. It's gone completely. Well done. You're very technical over there on the Isley widget, aren't you?
Sure. We've done these things many times before. There's still a tiny bit of an echo there, and I don't know why that is. But yes, you are live now, Chris Reardon, on www.vectisradio.com. Welcome, Ray!
This is the pinnacle of my career. It really is. I've always wanted to be on the Isle of Wight Radio, also known as...
Don't say that! Oh, no!
What have I said?
It's not that. They're the competition up the road. I'm going to cut you off for that.
Who are?
What you just said, we're Vectis Radio, we're not Vectis Radio, you can't say that.
Isle of Wight on the radio. That's what I meant, dear. Oh, don't worry about tiny little things like that,
That's it, I've got the sack now, 4 years of radio career, okay. And I'll be gone,
bye.
This will be the last
bye.
Show.
Bye, bye. Here, you know, your lovely daughter, do you go to church as well, or is it only your daughter?
No, I do as well.
You do as well. Well, I went to a new church this morning.
A new one?
Yeah, I'll tell you why. Because last night I was doing a little karaoke night in Maidenhead. It's my last one there. Then I've picked up a new regular job in London. A very easy job in London on Saturday night. So I've decided to go for that. Anyway, the Maidenhead one finishes at 2 o'clock. And I take speakers and everything like that. So by the time I get home and to bed, and, you know, I had to have a cup of tea when I got in as well. It was like 3:30. Now, normally, if I want to go to the church in Wokingham for 9 o'clock, I have to get up at 7:30. So I went to bed about 3:30. You know, you drift off maybe 3:45 if you're lucky. Then you're up again at 7:30. And I've done it a couple of times now. And it really is a bit much. Last time I did it, I came back from church and I was so tired and I went back to bed at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, you know, losing an entire day. So I decided last night while I was at work, I had a look at other churches in the area and I found one in Sunningdale, which is Church of the Sacred Heart. Now, this one is a bit different to the ones I've been going to because it's run by missionaries. So you've got like a large house next to this church. And I've never been in there before. So I didn't set my alarm. I checked out. There was a mass at 10 and one at 11:30. I thought, well, I'll go to the 11:30 one. I'll see what time. And if I wake up at 7:30, I do. So I didn't set the alarm. And I woke up, as luck would have it, about 8:50. Well, my normal church is 9 o'clock. Yeah, so I wasn't going to make that. And I had my breakfast and I looked at the clock. It was 20 past. And I thought, do you know, I think I'll make the 10 o'clock mass this morning. So I jumped in my car. It's about 14, 15 minutes down the road. And I went into the church, first time ever. And it's lovely. And the colour scheme is kind of yellow. It's quite bright in there. Very nice. So we had a few hymns. No, I think it was only about 2 people in the choir. Not many people singing in there, which meant they could hear my voice, Vectis. And you know how I like to sing in church. We like to do all the hymns. Disappointingly, the Gloria wasn't sung, but never mind. So we did that. I did that, and I enjoyed that this morning. Yeah, going to a different church.
Well, I think as the listeners can tell, Chris, you certainly like to send your own voice.
Beg your pardon, dear. What do you mean by that, dear?
Nothing. Don't take offence.
How rude are you?
I mean, it's my show. For heaven's sake, I'll let you on my show.
But it's also Chris's show as well.
Well, you asked me to talk, so I spoke. I mean, I left gaps there if you wanted to interject. Is that the quiet word? Interject at that point? Feel free to interject. Go on, I'm waiting.
As you can tell, dear listeners, my mate Chris Reardon does a very much a talk-based show. More a video show as well. You always show yourself as well, don't you, Chris?
I like to say television. It's more television. I am a television personality here now on the mainland, which you probably know by now anyway. They're looking at me to replace the girl on the test card now. But unfortunately, I can't keep my mouth closed enough for them to take the photograph.
And how did your gig go last night? Because it's a bit late for you now, isn't it? Because you're getting on in years.
Oh, yeah, and that's one of the other reasons I...
It's only a few years between you two.
No, he's a lot older than me.
No, he's not.
How old are you, Vectis?
49.
51.
49.
51.
You're 51. Well, there's only 3 years difference between us. That's why we get on so well.
But some people age much better than others, don't they, Chris?
I know. Look at your daughter. Christ, I thought it was your mother when I first met you.
Charming.
Anyway, this is the man itself. I've often spoke about you on my show and our couple of trips we've had up to London. Some more successful than others, I hasten to add. So now people can put a voice to the voice, if that makes any sense at all.
A voice to the voice, yeah, it does. That does make sense, I suppose.
Anyway, I must go, and I'll let you do what you do.
Oh, so soon! I can't believe you're going so soon. Because I wanted to just tell you, before you go, if I can just get a word
in
edgeways here.
You've got 2 minutes before I go to an ad break, so you don't have to worry about these things, do you?
Well, how long have you got to put an ad on for?
It's all right. You've got 2-3 minutes. It's all right.
2 or 3. Well, I don't know if I can say all I want to say in 2 or 3 minutes.
Just start now, quick.
I'll start now. So after church, I then went over to Sainsbury's. I drove back and popped into Sainsbury's. Not my favourite supermarket, as you know. Unless, of course, Sainsbury's advertise on your radio station, in which case you should go in there every single day and spend as much money as possible.
You've got the idea of this commercial radio, haven't you? I'll give them that.
So I've gone into Sainsbury's. Other supermarkets are available. Right, I've gone into Sainsbury's. Oh, I know all the rules. I just don't stick to them. And the first thing that I've got, as the sliding doors open, whoosh, and he walks past the security man who's staring into his television screens, what was on the right? Go on, have a wild guess. Have a guess what was on the right as I walked in, and there were stacks of them.
Oh, Easter eggs.
No. Second attempt. Try again.
Beef burgers.
Only one more try. Get ready to steal the answer, the Shania family.
You have a go.
I don't have a clue.
No, you've got another chance. No, you've got another chance first. It's family fortunes. You've got one more chance.
Go.
Valentine's cards.
Ooh. Very close. Shania family, get ready to steal the prize.
Flowers or something, I don't know.
Correct!
Yes, I win!
You win! You know what you've won, don't you? Hang on, where are they? You know what you've won? You know, I haven't sent yours off yet. Just a moment. You've won.
He doesn't know yet.
Are we up to the ad breaks yet, dear?
Just keep going.
Just keep going.
You have won a United Kingdom talk mug.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Here it is, which I haven't sent off. Here it is. A United Kingdom with a little photograph of me on there as well. So that each time you put this to your lips, it's just like kissing me.
Oh, that's
lovely. Isn't that lovely?
Now.
So, going into Sainsbury's, there's all these flowers on the right and there are stacks and stacks of red roses. See who can get closest to the price. How much do you think in Sainsbury, bear in mind it's a supermarket, not a florist, not a garden centre, a supermarket. Stacks and stacks of them. How much for 2 dozen red roses?
Mm.
In Sainsbury's, remember?
£10.
£10 for 2 dozen? Okay.
No, maybe not, actually.
No?
I don't know. Vectis?
I'll say 15, something silly like
that. 50 quid?
Yeah.
50 quid in Sainsbury's?
No, 15.
15? Okay, 15. Okay, Shania, do you want to change your answer before it gets locked in? You have 5 seconds.
£20.
£20? Is that your final answer?
Yeah, go for it.
Final answer?
Yeah.
Up a bit? Left a bit? Right a bit?
I'll stick with 20.
Fire? Okay. Sticking with £20? The answer is, ding, 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 £48.
What?
Sainsbury's are charging £48 for 2 dozen roses in a box.
I still win, though, because I've got a higher answer than...
Which is twice as much as their slightly less offer. A dozen roses is £24. So you would think if you buy 2 dozen, it would be like 40, wouldn't you? You know what I mean? No, they've doubled the price. £48 for 2 dozen roses in Sainsbury's. And I'm not being funny. They didn't even look that good.
And someone like you, Chris, who loves so many people, it must cost you a fortune. It must cost you about £1,000 to buy all those roses.
Dear me, I don't send flowers to anyone, I'm afraid. No, anyway, the last lot of flowers
Chris,
I bought...
I've got to earn the station some money, but no, it's still good to you.
Cheerio, bye-bye.
Bye.
There we are. Wasn't that exciting? We were like... I think he got fed up talking to me then. Do you? £48 for 2 dozen roses. You must be off your head to go in there and pay that. I mean, I thought they were that at the florist or somewhere like that. Didn't you? Anyway, it's only a couple of days now till the old Valentine's Day. My advice to you, leave it a week and then take them out for a meal or something like that. If you want to buy flowers, do it in a week's time. Do not go somewhere and pay a vast sum of money for some half-eaten, moth-eaten, because they look awful. They don't even look nice. They don't. And they don't smell. Why don't roses smell anymore? Complete and utter waste of money. It really is. Now, let's have a look. Elaine likes the graphics. Thank you, Elaine. Well, the beginning. Have you never seen those before? Ah, yes. You probably join us a little bit later, don't you, Elaine? So, hello. Good morning to Sharon Stone. Hello, Sharon. Nice to see you, darling. Kiki D's with us. Sean is enjoying our little title section things and everything like that. Good morning to Alan Carruthers. Hello, sir. Adam says, the mirror ball. The mirror ball is turning as always. Adam, okay. Good morning to Stephen Robert McMillan. Good afternoon to you, sir. Oh, it's afternoon, isn't it? Joanna, there you are. Did you hear my opening speech at the beginning, Joanna? Did you hear that at all, my love? We've got someone else calling
hello.
In now. Hello, who's that?
Yeah, hello.
Hello. Oh, you got cut off. Got cut off. Do you want to try that again? Call back in again and I'll take you again, all right? Yes, Joanna, we were chatting about you earlier, right at the beginning of the show. I don't know if you heard it or not, my love. OK, good afternoon to Tony Power. On the subject of the Diane Abbott and what was his name? The other bloke trying to kiss. Tony says it would be like kissing Moby Dick, kissing Diane Abbott. I wonder if she does tongues or not. How awful. Hello to Paul Dow. Most politicians are gay, dear. Why is that, Paul? Have you been with most of them? You know, Paul doesn't care. He goes with anyone, don't you, Paul? Hello to Rod Brown. Afternoon, Rod. Hello to Timothy Thomas. Good God, didn't realise you're 54. Yeah, I'm 54 now, Tim. That was last week. Got nice, a few nice little gifts from people, including this wonderful book from Wendy Young, who's a regular correspondent, viewer, listener to the show. And it's The Book of Chris. Now, I said to you, Wendy, I don't know, but you'll be watching this at some point. I don't know if you're with us live this morning. But I did say to you, this is bedtime reading. Wendy, I don't want you to be disappointed with me when I tell you that this has become my bathroom toilet book. You don't mind that, do you? Is that okay? You don't mind? So, you know, do you have books in the toilet or magazines? Or do you take your iPhone in there? Do you take your iPhone? Please don't disappoint me and tell me you've got something other than an iPhone. I don't want people ringing in who have got those nasty little Nokias or Galaxies or things like... I mean, Galaxy is something you eat, dear. It's very, very nice chocolate. Don't embarrass yourself by ringing in on anything else than an iPhone. And if it's not iPhone, only iPhones 5s and above. I only want calls from people on iPhones 5 or above. You know, you can't even get into John Lewis if you've got anything else. They won't let you in anymore. That's it. Anyway, so this book from Wendy. I hope you don't mind, Wendy. This has become my toilet bathroom book. And I generally visit the book, the little room, about three times a day to have a little bit of a sit down. And I read a bit to you yesterday. And I've got to the first page now. And it's all about me and being 54. So here's the first section in it. 54, it says, frankly, it's an amazing age to be. Except the fact that you have to have glasses now because you can't see a damn thing. I was trying to read, what was it? Someone gave me something last night. I was trying to read the label on the side. No chance whatsoever. 54 is the age Harry J. Hemlich developed his life-saving emergency maneuver. Now, you know what that one is. That's where you stand behind someone when they've got something stuck in their throat. And you, whoo, and they, whoo, you pull them back and it's supposed to dislodge whatever is stuck in their throat. I've been very, very lucky in my life. I've never really had anything stuck in my throat. Fifty-four is the atomic number of xenon, which is used in lights. It could also turn your lights out when used as a general anaesthetic. Oh, I might have to have that soon. They want to put a camera down my stomach at some point. Although, I have to say, things are working pretty well at the moment down in that area. I've had stomach problems now for about a year. But the last couple of weeks, they have been improving, I'm quite pleased to say. 54 is the average period in year that ellipses tends to repeat at the same location on the Earth. So very, very interesting stuff in it. And there's so much here to read. Look, ants. Chris the Ant. To mark this historic occasion, Wendy Young has taken the liberty of naming an ant. I'm going to show you a picture in a minute. An ant in your honour. Oh, it gets better and better, doesn't it? You see, the common people, they have stars named after them, you know. You've seen, you can do that. You can go and, oh, I'd like to name that star. And you send off 50 quid or whatever to someone and a star is named after you. I, of course, am a star anyway, so I don't need that. I've had an ant named after me, boys and girls. Wendy Young has taken the liberty of naming an ant in your honour at the Book of Everyone Ant Farm. You can catch all the antics of Chris the Ant online with our webcam at www.thebookofeveryone.com/antfarm. Or the Book of Ants on Twitter. Look, there it is. There is the actual ant that has been named after me. Isn't that fantastic? I bet you haven't got an ant named after you, have you? No! No ant! Look! Diane Abbott couldn't have an ant named after her, could she? You know, because she'd be too fat to have an ant like that. No. So that has become a toilet book, and I hope that's okay, Wendy. Incidentally, boys and girls, Wendy has sent a message in. Now, do you remember on yesterday's show, I showed you these two lovely bags, okay? Now, I like to buy bags for my sister and my niece for birthdays and Christmas time. I bought them a couple, and then I said to you yesterday, let me find this one, because it is particularly nice. You might not have seen this yesterday. Where is it now? Oh, I thought it was on the front page somewhere. Wasn't it on the front page? One second. There it is. I bought them a couple of bags each. And then I said to my niece, what can I get my sister? And it got to my sister's birthday, you know, like 2 years later. And I said to my niece, what can I buy your mum this year? I said, I bought her a couple of bags. I better buy her something different. And my niece says, you can never have enough bags. That's what my niece said. So I carried on buying bags. And I came across this one in the latest Harrods magazine. Oh, this is the beautiful magazine. There is stuff here. There's always stuff here that there's no way you could ever dream to afford something like this, like chandeliers, like $100,000 for a chandelier. Right, and check this bag out here. Look at this. This Gucci bag. Look, there it is. This Gucci bag there. Look, do you like that? Isn't that lovely? And I was asking yesterday, could someone look at the price? And Wendy has looked this up for us. She says, here's the handbag you were talking about on your show yesterday. I had to have a nose and was bored. Can't sleep. £1,450 for that bag. Look at that. Look at, just imagine all those caravan holidays you could have for that, boys and girls. £1,450 for a bag. Can't afford that? No problem. We can find something a little cheaper for you. A puzzle bag. Here it is. This is the low bag. The low bag. Oh, no, hang on. It's dearer. Hang on. How much was that one? 1575. 1 minute. 1450. No, that's the Gucci one is the cheaper one. The Gucci one is the cheaper bag. There it is. There again. I quite like that. I do like that bag. I could see myself turning up at gigs with my laptop in one of those. Here is the low bag. Very, very nice indeed. And Wendy's also looked that up for us. This is the low bag at £1,575. Yeah. Oh, can't afford that? No problem. You can buy just the shell strap. Because the strap, you see it goes, it hooks on there with one of those, you know, those like those little clip things that you do on each end. You can buy just the belt for just £875 for the strap. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? And one day I will buy my sister something like that. I would like to. Do you know what I mean? Not quite yet. We're still saving. Not quite yet. But I would like to buy my niece and nephew some things like that. You can call in if you want to this afternoon, boys and girls. The phone number is 020-8144-3477, OK? 020-8144-3477. If you've got Skype, you can use the Skype in as well. My Skype in name is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. United Kingdom Talk, the Skype in, or the phone number 020-8144-3477. Light-hearted show, we don't do too serious on here. You know how it goes, all right? Let's have a look. Scrolling up slightly. Good afternoon to Paul Adamson, who says, on the subject of Diana Abbott, have you seen her teeth? No, I haven't, dear. They can't be any worse than the people on the Jeremy Kyle show. Have you seen, at least she's got teeth, mind. Have you seen them on there? One tooth. You slept with my mother. These young girls come on there, don't they? And they're screaming and shouting at their parents on there. Why would you ever want to do that? How do you think that makes you look? If you was to go on the Jeremy Kyle show, right, and your mother's sitting there and you come on screaming and shouting, how do you actually think you look to people? You know, I mean, people will be watching you and you will be hated. I hate using that word, but I will. People will hate you for whatever reason for shouting at your mum, even if she did sleep with your boyfriend and your pet dog. You know, my mum slept with my dog and I'm not having it. Oh, ghastly people, dear. Ghastly. I'm so glad there weren't any of them in the church in Sunningdale this morning. I really am. Hello to Mark Bonner. How did last night go at the corner house? Was it very busy? Yes, Mark. It was very good in there last night. I started at 10 o'clock is my start time there. And we started indeed at 10 o'clock. Few singers coming in. And then we get a mass of people coming in. And they're all nice people, actually. Some really good looking lads and girls in there. My God, I wasn't really looking at the girls, but there was. Oh, my word. Very, very nice looking. But as always, Mark, nothing for me, I'm afraid. Yeah, nice night there. But it was my last night there because I've picked up Saturday nights, most Saturday nights at Central Station in King's Cross now. So I've finished there now. Timothy Thomas says, a large house besides a mission is called a mission house. Odd that, don't you think? Well, I didn't even know that. It's a mission house. A mission house, yes. So they've got four priests who work in there. And you know, when you go in a church, if you're on your own, there's always someone or a couple that start talking to you, always. You know, and I sat next to this bloke. I said, does anyone usually sit here? He said, no, you're all right. Sit there, he said. He said, in fact, I come in here and I look for people. This is the bloke sitting next to me, him and his missus. He said, I look for people that sit in the same chair every time. And then next time I come in, I go and make sure I sit in their chair just to offend them. I like the thinking of that. I do like the thinking of that. Although with the other church in Bracknell that I used to go to, there's a little old lady that used to sit directly behind me. Now, what was her name? She's a foreigner. She was Spanish. I can't remember her name now. But she was lovely, she was. And if she came in and there was someone sitting there, she'd push in. She'd, excuse me, can I just get in there? And she'd push it, but she'd be nice about it. It's a bit like the elderly people that go run and jump the queue at the bus at 9 o'clock in the morning. My nan used to do that. Honestly, she would see a queue of people, you know, waiting to get on this bus. And as the bus would approach and as the doors open, that's it. She would take off at the back and go, round the back, excuse me, can I go on? And she'd just push in, my nan. Nanny Hayes. I've got a photo of her here. Oh, is there a photo of her here? No, I don't think there is one. I used to have all photos on the wall in front of me until I decorated in here a few years ago. No, I can't find... Oh, hang on. Yes, there might be. There might be one here. Hang on. Nanny Hayes, are you there? Where's Nanny Hayes? no. No, I don't think there is. Oh, what's this here? Hang on. That's a broken bit of glass, I think. No, that's not one there. It's Mum. Oh, what a shame. Thought I might have a picture of Nanny Hayes to show you. She's been gone a few good amount of time now. Sean says, I want a United Kingdom talk mug. Well, you've missed it, dear. You've missed your chance, Sean. Weeks ago, I announced it at the end of one of my shows for my regular listeners that listen all the time. You'll have to wait for the next lot to come. If another lot come, dear, there might not be any more, Sean. You'll have to... You see, you only get these things by being a regular viewer and listener. You've got to watch all the shows all the way through because you never know when another offer might come across. 2 days ago, I gave away a car. 3 days ago, a holiday in Sicily for 3 weeks. But you missed it, Sean, because you're not there all the time, dear. It's like reading a book. Do you read a book? You know, page one, page two. Oh, I'll go to page 20 now, page 20, page 21. I'll go to page 50 now, page 50, page... No, you don't, dear. Well, that's what you've done with this show and you've missed out. There you go. There you go, love. Jerry Green says $12.99. What's that for? What's $12.99, Jerry? Roses somewhere. Oh, the roses in Sainsbury's. No, 24 quid. It's a lot of money for roses. Let's go to the phones. Ray Reynolds is calling in from London. Good evening, Ray.
Ray is in Woodford Green, Essex.
Hello, Ray. Isn't it funny? Throughout the whole show, I will either say good morning, good afternoon, or good evening. Yeah. I can never make up my mind. Mind you, you could be watching at any time if you're watching a recording. So I'm thinking of...
Yes, I'm watching you live as it happens.
You see, I'm being politically correct there, Ray. Right?
You always are.
I'm trying to include everyone, not just the people in the afternoon.
I was ringing in because I heard the prizes mentioned and things you're sending out. I've got my mug. Thank you very much. Make everyone jealous.
Yes.
But I was wondering if it was a chance to go for the car.
Sorry?
Because you were giving out prizes, a chance to go for the car. I wondered if I could be included in that.
You want to go for the car?
Speedboat? Has the speedboat gone?
It's gone. It's gone, I'm afraid. Da 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 da
From Norwich, it's the quiz of the week.
It's the quiz of the week. He's still around, isn't he?
Let's have an instant sale.
An instant sale. Here, you know when you watch some of those old quiz shows on the telly, right?
Oh, I love it. I can see your boom, by the way. That's a television expression. Boom in view.
Oh, you can see that. Yeah, just at the side.
I can just see the side of the boom.
I'm going to move it along a lot. Do you want me to do it now?
No.
Oh,
no.
God's sake, man. Honestly, they moan, dear.
Look, there it is, yeah.
There's always something wrong.
Perfect the other day, but that's fine. It was perfect the other day, but it's just in view. Yeah, in the early days of TV, if the boom came down on the actors or the performers, they said, oh, that's boom in view, they'd say from the gallery.
Oh, is that a technical word? Is it that
boom
right?
In view. Yeah, the boom used to come down. You see it in very old recordings programs. You see sometimes see the boom. Used to see it in Crossroads, yes. Suddenly the boot, and they hit their head on, didn't they? Made a joke of it.
Oh, it happened all the time. That did. I can't stand it. I'm gonna have to move this now because you're moaning.
Oh no, I'm not moaning.
Oh, I'm gonna have to.
You like little criticisms.
Eh?
It's not a moan. It's a criticism.
Exactly. Even worse. Even worse. A criticism of my very, very, very hard to do program, dear.
Criticism.
The only thing is, I can't get the damn thing unscrewed.
I'll change the subject. You know when you spoke about your nan?
I can't do that. Yep, go
on.
You
know you spoke about your nan just now, reminded me of, not Victoria Wood, what's Victoria Wood's best sidekick? What was her name? Victoria Wood died. Who was her sidekick? Who was in...
Don't know.
Who was in personal services?
Oh, yes, Cynthia Payne.
Pardon?
Cynthia Payne.
No, not Cynthia Payne, the actress.
Oh.
Oh. Victoria Wood.
I can look it up.
People are screaming at the television. Anyway, one sketch she shouts out, "Let me through, I'm diabetic." Do you remember?
Yes.
It sounded like your nan jumping the queue in the bus.
Julie Walters.
Julie Walters, yeah.
Julie Walters, yeah.
But at least I remembered the late Victoria Wood. She was good, wasn't she? David's a big fan. He can quote a lot of those lines, you know, much cleverer than anything that you and I do. He knows it off by heart.
Is that our friend, David?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He's always friends.
I think she had a huge, huge gay following. I think, you know, that's why some of these guys, I mean, the ones who don't do drag, they're wonderful actors. Some of the gay fraternity, they've got it.
Yeah,
they know it. They can do it.
Oh, it is good, though. I like personal service. Years since I watched that film. I must put that on again. And when Dolly with a Willy.
You were mentioning it. And I was in Gran Canaria once with my dad in a hotel.
Because
I used to go to Gran Canaria.
It's a funny person to take to Gran Canaria with you.
I used to go with my mates, and as I got older, my dad needed a carer, and when he could still fly, I took him to Gran Canaria. So we're sitting in the hotel there, I think it's the Waikiki, if people know the Waikiki. And all of a sudden, I looked at the next table to me, and it was Cynthia Payne. It was the Cynthia Payne. I'd seen her at a charity event where Sue Pollard was. I think it was the White Bear. It was upstairs in the White Bear.
Yes.
And I think the guests could go upstairs. Don't ask me how I got in upstairs. And then there was a show with Lee Paris and Dockyard Doris. Oh, that's where I got it. Yeah, I was a friend of Dockyard. And Victoria Payne was there. So I did meet her there. And I was able to tell her. I said, they're rerunning the Dame Edna shows. And you were on the first one with Cliff Richard. And so she was pleased to hear that UK Gold were showing the Dame Edna shows.
So you spoke to her then?
A few years later, so I'm in Gran Canaria, sitting at the table with my dad, and it's Cynthia Payne with a man or whatever. So I was able to talk to her. Because afterwards, my dad said, "Who was that?" I said, "Oh, that's Cynthia Payne." And I didn't like to say straight away, "Oh, she's the madam from Streatham."
Yeah.
Because he would have been a bit slow to know even what I know what a madam was. Certainly would be surprised if he was sitting next to Cynthia. Oh, she was lovely. Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. I don't think I could go up to a star or something if I just saw them.
Don't always do that. No. You have to know your time and place.
Yeah, and other people, they don't. And some of them don't like it. Cilla Black never used to like it.
No,
I know a couple of people that bumped into Cilla Black on aeroplanes.
You get put in your place very quickly.
Yes.
If it's in the right... I mean, obviously, a book signing, that's what they're there for.
Yeah.
A book signing's fine. You can go up and have a few words. Not too long, mate. No, I was talking about... Funny you should say that. Keith Harris. They showed Keith Harris. Remember with Orville
yes.
on the
Orville,
good old days.
Orville, who is
he
your very best friend.
He died very young. But I was down at the Cabaret Club. This was a gay hotel in Bournemouth. 25 years ago.
Yeah.
Anyway, I was sitting in the bar. It was on a Wednesday night. Before I went downstairs to the disco, there was nobody in the bar upstairs. Nobody at all. And it's a gay bar, and it's 25 years ago. And Keith Harris happens to live in Bournemouth, so he's not gay, but he wants to go in and have a late drink as an entertainer. Lots of them used to do that, you know, because they want to get a drink. And he knew the people who ran the bar. So he's straight at the bar, and of course, I'm the only one at the table. So I was able, hardly getting out of my seat, to say, "Oh, hello." And the reason I said hello so quickly is because I'd seen him just a few weeks before in a show with Larry Grayson at Great Yarmouth. So I said, "Oh, it's lovely to meet you." I said, "I saw you a few weeks at Great Yarmouth with Larry Gray." He said, "Yeah, we've got the same manager, Peter Dulé." People who remember Candid Camera, he used to compare that.
Yes, I remember that, Candid Camera, hilarious.
We were chatting away, just very, very ordinary. But, of course, you'd never do that if you he was in company or you just barged in. I mean, I'm a big radio fan, and I wanted my book signed by Johnny Walker. I was up at Harrods. But he was having a meal at a table at the pub opposite the Pier Hotel at Harrods. And I thought, well, no, I've got to use your loafer. You don't go up to them when they're eating their meal. You wait till they're finished and perhaps when they're just about to move off. Or if you see somebody else that's gone up just as they're on their coffee or something afterwards, finished. And that was all right. And he signed the book for me. But no, you can't. You've got to use your loaf. Otherwise, you'd be put in your place.
I can't go up to a star or anything like that. And as I say, some people don't like it. My mate has no problem doing it at all. He'll go up to him. I'm really, really sorry to write. He's very good at talking to people. He's like, I'm really, really sorry to write. And you can tell me to go away. Is there any chance I could have my photo taken?
Well,
he's got
a
few
photos done like that. Yeah,
and I just want to point out, Ray, you know, me being an international celebrity and television star, if people see me walking around in Waitrose or John Lewis, somewhere like that, and you want your photo taken, then just ask. No problem at all. You know,
Because,
you know, sometimes I'm in places and you do feel people's hand brush past you like they just want to touch you.
Yeah,
do you know what I mean? And I've had
that
a few times.
That superstar pub.
Yes. You haven't got to hide that. You know, just ask me, can I have a photo? And it's no problem. You can take 10 if you want. I don't mind. You know, all different sort of, you know, poses. Okay. I can do the lips. I can do the lips.
Wonderful. You know, I've seen those lips. Can I get a plug in for Central Station?
Yes, if you want to, because you're on Tuesday, aren't you?
I'm there on Tuesday, and I'm playing some clips. It's LGBT month, and Duncan usually asks me if I can show some clips of the old drag artists like Regina Fong and Dot Yard Doris and Phil Starr.
Do you do that on your computer?
It's funny you should say that. I've got all these things on DVDs. Last year, we transferred them onto so it could be played on the PC. But I want to try and avoid that this time because it's a bit time-consuming. But I've got them ready to go on DVD, but whether or not we...
You know what, Ray? You stick to the format that you're happy with.
Of course.
Absolutely.
Well, I'm retired now as a DJ. If I did DJ anymore, I'd go back to DVDs. I wouldn't know where to start with a PC and a stick. You know, I wouldn't know where to start. You know?
Other people would look at that as a bit clunky, but, you know, you stick with the format that you're happiest with. That's what
I'd
say.
Right,
absolutely, yeah.
Do you remember when I did the jingles for Regina at the Black Cat? They were on cassettes.
Yes, I remember.
And he used to guard them. He used to put them on a little shoebox. And Rosen would have them on the counter. And he'd have the cassettes in a little shoebox or smaller than that.
Yeah, I remember.
And then that was his act on the cassettes. Gosh. And they were little computer cassettes. I think they were 15 minutes.
I think they used to do karaoke with cassettes. You know, you'd have a box of cassettes and like your words written out on bits of paper. Karaoke.
If anybody remembers there won't be many of your listeners, viewers who remember the Black Cat originally 1969.
Ah, well, you have to remember there won't be many Black Cat people watching this. They'll be from all over, so they won't know what you're talking about now.
Norman, as you know, Norman's got my good DJ friend. He's a bit older than me. His best friend was Frankie Ray, who played the organ for the performers in The Black Cat.
Was it Wurlitzer? Wurlitzer?
It was one of those, Wurlitzer organ, and very powerful. And it was powerful enough to back all the drag artists.
Yeah.
And I can remember he would play anything for you, almost with one finger. The technology was coming along. And he would play the background music before we had the main artist. There was no disco, background music or whatever, show music. But when he was ready to put the drag on, he'd get his cassette, you'd see him get the cassette, and he'd get a pencil, and he'd rewind sometimes the pencil, rewind it back a little bit further with a pencil, and he'd put it in the machine, and he'd say, "And now, ladies and gentlemen, the wonderful Mr. Mark Fleming," and he'd play the music if he wanted a particular act. Mark Fleming is not a very good example because he was completely live. But some of the drag acts, they come on and they would mime to a cassette. Yeah, and I could always see him rewinding it with a pencil now and then playing the organ. Yeah, he was a lovely guy, Frankie Ray. Lots of the drag performers, you know, used to have weren't happy enough just with a keyboard player or organ man playing the organ. They had a drummer. They would get, say, they'd get somebody in, a straight guy playing the drums, just for the drag act, so it would give it that much more panache, of a show. They were used to that. That was when Mimax were beginning to, Mimax were beginning to be a bit old-fashioned, and people were starting to, well, certainly the Black Cat, they want a live show at 8:30, live show.
Yeah, it's quite nice to have a keyboard and a drummer. When I was in the Scouts, gang show, did you ever see a gang show?
Oh, yes. Right? Yes,
when I was in the Scout gang show, yeah. I was in the Roehampton one and the South London one, the South London one was actually held in a girls' school, Catford Girls' School. They had a big stage and all that. And generally, gang shows were the Scouts. They were done at school halls or large colleges, places like that. Rarely at theatres and places like that. Although the London one was of course, a big theatre. Years ago, this was Ralph Reeder wrote all that. Yeah. And we had a piano player. It wasn't an organ, it was a piano. And a drummer. And a bass guitar. And we had a bass guitarist. That's all we had. And that was really good to have those three things there. And that works very well, you know.
Norman Scott's uncle used to play the piano for Ralph Reeder. He knew him personally. That's the sort of era even before my time, just before, well, the early days, I can just remember the early days of ITV, 1955, but just before that, gang shows and people like Huey Green, they were big stars on Radio Luxembourg when they used to, not just...
Oh, Huey Green was on Radio Luxembourg, was he?
Yes, they used to do Money on, before television, they did W Money on the radio.
Well, I didn't know that.
Green, and they did Take Your Pick on the radio, Radio Luxembourg. Before we had ITV.
Was he on Thames first or Rediffusion?
It was called Associated Rediffusion.
He was on Rediffusion. Yeah, that was before Thames, wasn't it?
That was 5 days a week in the London area, and then at the weekends it was ATV.
When did Thames take that over?
I think it was about 1968, I'm guessing.
Oh, so after I was born then? That was after I was born then,
Yeah.
All right, Ray. Just before you go, you're on a normal house phone, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah, you can just... I've said this so many times before. People with iPhone 7 in particular who ring in and they move their head slightly and you
lose
it.
Away from the mouthpiece, yeah.
The quality of that call has been perfect. Absolutely perfect. Just goes to show you, doesn't it?
The old-fashioned way.
All that technology, and it doesn't work. Thanks, Ray.
All the best to you.
See you tomorrow night, all right? Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye.
There we are. Ray Reynolds calling in there. He's one of our karaoke people. If you've never seen it before, we do stream our karaoke live on Facebook every Monday and Friday. Generally, Monday it starts round about 8:10 and Friday round about 8:40. We always start, you know, quite shortly after we actually start doing the karaoke. And you'll see Ray Reynolds there. Sometimes he sings songs on his own or sometimes he brings his ukulele. Actually, they bought me a mini... Do you want to see it? If you haven't seen this already, just a minute. Ray and Reynolds bought me this mini little ukulele, which I don't think I'll be able to play. I can't play strings. I'm a keyboard player, and I can't read music. I'll just play by ear. Look, they bought me this for my birthday. Look at this. A United Kingdom Talk ukulele. Da-da-da-da-da-da. When I'm cleaning windows, and you hold it up there, quite high. It's not a mini guitar. It's a ukulele, a uke. They call them ukes, and it comes in a little blue case and all that, which is very kind of you. Thank you, boys. Let's go back to some of these messages. Let's have a look here. How far did we get? Ryan says £48 for two dozen roses. I know. He's shocked. As is Dino. £48. Don't spend £48 on roses in Sainsbury's. Don't be stupid. And they'll get forgotten. Within 10 minutes, they'll have forgotten about them. Don't bother. Waste of money. It really is. Hello to Sharon Stoned, who says he picks them off people's gardens. What, the roses? Good idea. Sharon Stoned wants a mug. You've missed them, Sharon. All gone, darling. You must have missed the shows that we were doing. Hello to Shania, who says, did you enjoy the phone call on the radio station? Yes, indeed, I did. Joanna came in late. You'll have to watch the early part of the show later on, my darling. Kiki D says, you should rent your bed seeing as you're a celebrity TV person. Now, that was the story, Kiki D, which was in the Daily Mail this morning. I'm sure it was, and I can't find it again. I was going to read that to you. You can stay in the bed of a celebrity. Absolutely. I'll see if I can find it for another show. Good morning to Michael Milner, who just sends me question marks. What's that mean? I've just got question marks for me. I don't know what that means. Thank you, Ryan, for your happy belated birthday wishes. Sean says, I do plungering in the bathroom. Hello to Kevin Webster. Hi, Chet. Would you like my cold? No, thank you very much. We don't do colds. Hello to Jason Carter. Gustav says, don't worry, Sean. The lead paint comes off the mugs if the water's too hot. They're a danger to life. And do you remember that lead paint? God knows why we're not all dead, to be honest. Sarita's with us, who loves the Dalek in the background. The Dalek does something, Sarita. It doesn't just sit there. Check this out. Look, you push a little... Now, I've had this Dalek about 5 years. Of my life, I've had this 5 years. But it actually does something. Look, look.
You would make a good Dalek.
Do you like that? Do you want to hear it again? Look. One minute. I'll do it again. Here we go.
Exterminate.
See? You want one of these, don't you? Keith George is on the line. Hello, Keith. Coming to you live from Torremolinos. Well, where is it again?
No, I'll tell you where I am right now.
Oh.
The shame of it. I'm sitting on the top deck of a 156 bus outside the Arndale Centre in Wandsworth.
Oh, you're on a bus? Where are you off to?
Wimbledon.
I tell you what, that Arndale Centre. Now, I lived in Wandsworth until 1992.
Yeah.
And even at that date, you could... No, hang on. Was it 82? Yeah, 1992. Yeah. And even then, you could drive slightly past the Arndale Centre and you could just park on the main road,
yeah.
Garrett Lane.
Yeah.
You can't do that anymore, yeah. Mate.
No.
Yellow lines everywhere. And look how different the Arndale Centre looks. Have you been in there?
Yeah, I have. Yeah, it's very
different.
Gosh,
there's a cinema and everything in there now.
I know.
We thought we were doing well when Iceland opened. Where are you off to?
I'm going to meet my dad for lunch, and tomorrow I'm flying to Jamaica.
Oh, lovely.
Yes.
Down away where the nights are gay and the sun shines daily on the mountain top.
Mountain top.
I took a trip on the sailing ship. I think you should do that in one of your shows. Let me tell you, Keith George is an entertainment professional. He has a variety of characters. One includes Mandy Gap, who's a bit aggressive, according to some. Apparently a bit aggressive. Mandy Gap.
To King Jimmy, you mean?
Bit aggressive. And, of course, you do
he's
yourself.
He's a little bit ill.
Keith George.
Anyway, we won't talk about that.
Keith George.
Yeah, so we've got very different acts and whatever, but, you know. Anyway, I'm off to Jamaica tomorrow. I know you don't like long-haul flying. You
no.
can't bear it, can you?
No, I can't stand it, no.
I'm flying in club class.
Yeah, so do I. I hate
yeah,
it.
Yeah, and you just can't bear it. I think you can't... What part of it you can't bear?
I can't get comfortable in the seat.
But in the bed?
Even when you're laying down. Well, you can't stretch out, can you? You've got your arms are down by your side or, you know, or sometimes I put my arms, like, across my chest. You know?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, last time I did that, the trolley dolly come along. She says she thought I was dead because I looked like I was laying in a coffin. They started poking me while I was sitting there, dear. How rude. I said, yeah, I'm all... Yes, I said, yes, I'm all right. Go and get me another cheese sandwich, you lazy, nosy cow.
Did you have to not resuscitate?
Yeah, they'd written that on my forehead as I was laying there like that with my arms crossed on my chest. I looked like Mother Teresa without doing the good before.
Oh, don't.
Never mind. Well, you'll have a lovely time there. Is it just a holiday or a work thing?
I'm doing 6 days in Jamaica, and then I'm flying to Vegas because I'm performing in Vegas this time next Sunday.
Wow.
So I'm performing there. I'm performing at the Golden Nugget in Fremont Street, which is down in the old Vegas.
I know that, yeah.
But I'm excited because also the one and only Cher is on, and Diana Ross.
What, you're going to meet them?
No, I'm there on in the Vegas. They're staying at different hotels. Well, you know, like Diana Ross is on at the Venetian. And,
well, you never. They might
on at the Monte Carlo.
They might come and see your show.
particular. I hope so.
What you got? What you are you as yourself or one of the characters or what?
The Boy George Show.
Boy George Show. The Boy George.
I'm up for an award.
Oh yeah.
Yes, so I did send you the link. You obviously didn't vote, but never mind.
I'm sick to death with people sending me, oh, vote for me, vote for me.
People voting, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I know. You know.
Oh, that's wonderful.
That's good. Well,
the exchange rate is diabolical at the moment, though. 1.2, is it?
Rubbish.
1.2, that's the worst it's ever been.
Yeah.
I wonder, once it gets to like 1.2, is there any point in going doing the shopping? Or is it still a lot cheaper?
I don't think so. I don't think, I remember going when it was two something to the pound, you know. And just when you do lots of shopping and all that. But now, because I'm just going, I've taken all the stuff with me anyway, so I'm not really going to shop.
Yes.
I'm going more to perform and an audition. So... that's why I'm going.
Will you be taking any shows while you're there?
Pardon?
Will you be taking in any other shows while you're there?
Yeah, Cher and Diana Ross.
Oh, you're going to say Diana Ross? Wow. Imagine that, being in the same room as Diana Ross.
Yeah.
I felt like that when I was in the same room as Liza Minnelli, breathing in the air that she has just exhaled.
I went to see her perform when she was absolutely rubbish.
What, Liza Minnelli?
Liza Minnelli at Kenwood House, and she was absolutely
We didn't think that at all. I thought it was quite. She was quite. She coughed a lot, but that's just one of those things. But it doesn't matter how bad they are. You are in the same room as Liza Minnelli.
This wasn't the room. It was an open house. It was the open air.
Oh, right.
She was absolutely rubbish. And she couldn't. She started singing New York. And when she got to the end, but she couldn't do it. She stopped the band. She said, "I'm going to succeed in doing this." It was more. She was more being laughed at than laughed
with. Oh, really?
You know what I mean? We know she's all a bit... I just thought, well...
But that is her, isn't it?
Liza.
She's mad,
maybe
like us. Well, I'm mad anyway, you know.
Yeah, I know. But, I mean, you know when you're not on form or whatever, and you think, I'm not on form and blah, 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 you know. But she was shocking. And she kept drinking this hot drink, and every time she took some, and 10 minutes later, she'd be all over the place.
All right.
So whatever the drink was, I don't know. But it was fun.
Was it?
She tried to kick her legs up and slipped.
Do you think it was very strong then, Sip?
I think it was something with definitely whiskey in it.
Do you drink, Keith? I don't drink at all, do I? I don't teetotal.
I used to drink everything, as you know, back in the ski week trips, everything. And then back then I was, of course, very different. But now, I since January the 1st, I've drank twice.
Yeah.
The both times not enjoyed the next day.
Oh, right. Okay.
It's just that feeling the next day, you know.
Yeah, it's just not worth it, is it?
No, I think as we get older now, you know, that we've got more to do with our time, where before, you know, it was all important and all about us. And then, you know, now that we've got older, we've got probably less responsibility. Have more time on your hands, you do more things. I find I'm doing more things. I'm getting up early, I'm going to the gym, and then, you know, going for walks, swims and all that. And it takes up my day. And then I go home, have my lunch or my tea or whatever, and then chill out for an hour and then go to work. So I found that with the less responsibility and nothing more to worry about getting here, there and everywhere, work. But now... you don't have to really worry about it, because I think, I'm 45 now. What, you're 49, aren't you? It's your birthday soon,
54,
isn't it?
I'm 54.
When's your birthday?
I was last Sunday.
How would you? I did. I said, oh, you couldn't write on your wall. I had to write physically on your wall. That's right. That's 54, Chris.
Yeah.
How long have we known each other?
I don't know. It's mad, isn't it?
I was watching you, and I thought... Have you had something done?
No, I've had nothing done. I won't have anything done. I think it's just stupid having all that business done. Injections in your face and all that business. And the worst ones are those that have their lips done. What's that noise?
It's a bus, dear.
What's that? I heard a bleeping noise. Is that you?
The bus.
The bus to Wimbledon. Oh, yes, of course. I'm sorry. You're not on the top deck, are you?
I'm on the top deck.
Oh, my God. It all happens up there, you know. Very dangerous place.
Is it really?
Especially in Wandsworth. What a dump that is. I can't believe I live there.
I'm approaching Wimbledon.
Oh, Wimbledon. Oh, that's better. And where are you going again?
I'm going to lunch with my dad.
Lovely. Will you enjoy your lunch? I hope it's a vegetarian meal.
Yeah, we're both from vegetarian. Well, though my dad's he's having a liquid lunch. So, but I won't be. I'm going for the spit roast.
What, do you have to mash it all up or whisk it up and drink it in a straw or something?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if I'd like that. What do pureed roast potatoes taste like, I wonder?
Roast potatoes? That's what it tastes like.
Oh, stupid question, really, weren't
it? I will keep in touch and I will keep you informed of my goings-on.
Please do.
Live from Jamaica, live from Vegas. Any interesting people that I meet in Jamaica, that I think you might like to see a photo of.
Please send it through on the WhatsApp. Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Have a nice day, Keith.
Bye-bye.
Oh, isn't that lovely? Off on holiday. Isn't that lovely weather over there in Jamaica? I wonder how hot it is there. It's got to be about 80 or 90 degrees over there at the moment, isn't it? In Fahrenheit, of course. You know, British. We use British things on here. None of this centigrade, foreign centigrade thing. We don't do that, dear. Fahrenheit. About 80 or 90 degrees Fahrenheit over there, it must be. Thank you, Stuart. Julie Waters, we were talking about earlier, yes. Tim says, Ray mentioned Lee Paris. 20 years since Lee Paris passed. Really? 20 years since the drag queen Lee Paris passed over. My God. I tell you what shocked me when I picked up the paper yesterday and I found Whitney Houston 5 years ago. 5 years ago. I'm frightened to get in the bath. Terrible way to go, slipping in the bath. That's what, I haven't got a bath anymore, actually. I took my bath out when that happened. I thought to myself, I don't want to go slipping in the bath or something like that. I've just got a power shower. Power shower I've got. Tim also says, the hand touching you in the supermarket is the store detective. I don't think so, Tim. They trust me in Waitrose. I've got a scanner. Beep, beep. I scan my things as I go around, put them straight in my bag. They don't even check me. I've only had 2 checks. You know, because sometimes when you're doing that self-scanning thing, they check you now and again to check that you're not nicking. Well, I've been checked twice. In fact, the first time I was checked, I'd actually put through more stuff than I had in my bag. So, how can I put this? If the price was supposed to come to £3... It came to £4. So it was actually in their favour. But I don't matter. It doesn't matter to me because I love going in Waitrose. If I pay a little bit more than I'm supposed to, I'm happy with that. They're nice people in there. Those lovely people behind the desk. Michelle is my favourite member of staff in Waitrose Bracknell. Michelle is the favourite, followed very closely by Linda. And then a few others. Jackie's in there. Jackie's not quite at the top. Jackie, I'm sorry, Jackie. You're not at the top because you came from Sainsbury's, lovey. You know, she came from Sainsbury's to Waitrose. So that's not quite the same. Do you know what I mean? Kiki D says, I've got a criticism. Your shirt collar is below your jacket neckline and it's bugging me. Is it? 1 minute. It's just, sorry about that. I'm really not very good at dressing, I'm afraid. You should know that by now, Kiki D, you gorgeous lady. Let's have a look. Stuart says, love to see the quiz shows on live stream here, Chris. What quiz shows? Oh, I'd love to do quiz. I'd love to do a quiz show on the telly. You know, I think I'd be better than that Ben Shepherd. There's something very, very fake about that smile of it. Hello and welcome to the quiz show. What he does with those coins dropping down, and it's like, you know, like at the fun fair when you've got like coins, you know, on a thing, and that thing, and you drop a coin in, and then like some, and then coins drop down. It's like a giant version of that. The actual, I quite like the format of the show, but they need some. I'm fed up seeing Ben Shepherd. He's not one of my favourites. There's something quite fake about him. Adam says, talking of church, if you have the night off, pop into mine at Lewisham. I would, Adam, but it's like a trip into London. Do you know what I mean? I'm on a night off. I don't really want to be driving into London. Phone call coming in. Who's that, please? Oh, no, we've lost that. OK, finishing 169. Call back in again. I'll take your call, all right? Good. Now, let me just check. I don't like to miss out messages, my darlings. 1 second, let me come back to that. I've done something wrong now. What have I done wrong? Is that it? That's it. There we go. Ryan says you should do a Bruce Forsyth tribute. Oh, I'd like to do the Generation Game. That would be good. Life is the name of the game. Shut that door. Do you remember when Larry Grayson done that? Shut that door. The generation game. He was very good at it as well. Michael says, what are you using to do the live stream? It can't be your phone. No, it's a high quality Logitech C920 webcam that does the live stream. And the actual show is also recorded onto my iPhone as well, Michael. All right. Cordy says, better jacket today. Do you think so? Do you think so? I've got several jackets. You probably prefer, some people prefer some, other people prefer others. Thank you, Tony, for reminding me it was Leonardo DiCaprio. Ah, now just a minute. We might be able to find that story now. Leonardo DiCaprio. Let me see if I can find that story for you now. Higher bed, maybe? No. Got it. Here it is. Here's the story I wanted to tell you. What's the time? Blimey, it's 2:30. How did it get to that? I want to put my dinner on. I'll do this story and then we'll do today's birthdays and then we'll disappear. I haven't had my dinner yet. I'm practically disappearing before your very eyes here. Anyone else want to call in? You've got to do it nice and quickly. 020-8144-3477 is the phone number. 020-8144-3477. Or you can Skype in. My Skype in username is all one word, United Kingdom Talk, OK? So here we go. Like to spend the night in Leo DiCaprio's bed. Well, you can do this now. Look at this. Hang on a minute. Where's the bloody story gone there? Oh, I swore. Sorry. Here we go. I can't find the story now. It's all photographs. Where's the story gone? Where's the text? Oh, I can't find the story. I can read you the headlines, though. So, like to spend the night in Leo DiCaprio's bed. This is in this morning's Daily Mail. You can for £3,000. Just £3,000. And it says you can sleep in Leo's bed. Oh, wouldn't that be lovely? I wonder what that mucky old devil's been getting up to in there. If you envied Obama's break on Branson's Island, then check out a holiday at one of these stars' oh-so-swanky homes for hire. Leonardo DiCaprio rents his Titanic-sized Palm Springs mansion with cocktail bar in living room for £3,000. Now, it doesn't say how long that's for. Is that going to be for a week? Because actually, if that's for a week, that don't sound too bad for me. You could easily pay that, you know, taking a family to Disney. Bruce Willis's oceanfront home on the Turks and Caicos Islands, which is called The Residence, costs £6,490. Mick Jagger's Star Groves, a Japanese-style compound on Mustique. Now, I've been on the island of Mustique. Very nice. And if I remember rightly, you're not actually allowed to live there unless you've got a job on there, I think. So, of course, all these stars have got places on there. Oh, it's stunning. When you get off the little plane, because the little plane goes, not a jumbo jet, just so you've got to go to another island to get there. So you go to another island and you take a little plane to there. Or you did when I was there in 1996, I think it was. I went to Barbados and we went on these little trips. And the plane lands and you get off and there's this wonderful smell of flowers all around. It's beautiful, the island of Mustique. And it sits among coconut palms where you can rent Mick Jagger's Star Groves, a Japanese-style compound on Mustique, £2,400. It's getting better all the time. Or Prince Charles' private rural retreat in Transylvania, restored using traditional methods, will set you back, it says, £102. That's not bad, is it? Have a look in the Daily Mail. Perfect hideaway if you're a Wall Street wolf. Spend time in this Titanic Palm Springs mansion and sleep in the same luxurious bed as Leonardo DiCaprio. His fully furnished holiday home is available for, here we go, £3,000 a night. A night. Yes, so you'll need a wallet to rival Wolf of Wall Street, designed by a modernist architect. It's perfect for internet social gatherings. It does look very nice. Nice big swimming pool there. Let's have a look at Prince Charles's one. Hang on, where's that now? Is there one? Is there a picture of that? Where it is? Oh dear. Prince Charles's one is not nice at all. It's the one bedroom in Prince Charles's private rural retreat in Prince Transylvania, restored using traditional methods and materials. £102 a night. I'm sorry, it's not all that dear. Oh my word, no. I'm sorry, Charlie. That's very, very plain, I must say. So there you go. If you want to do something like that, you've got a little bit of cash to spare, you can stay at one of those places. Or you can come here. Now, I've got a spare room here. And for the paltry price of just £1,000 a night, you can stay. Extra for breakfast, I'm afraid. Extra for breakfast. I'll let you stay in my spare room for just £1,000. I've got a lovely duvet, a brand new duvet in there from Asda, £12. You can stay in the bed next door for just £1,000 a night. It don't get much better. I'm slightly dearer than Prince Charles, but a lot cheaper than Leonardo DiCaprio's place. And plus, you won't have the plane fares, will you? In fact, I will go and send my friend Ronnie in his BMW to come and collect you and take you to your holiday here in Royal Berkshire. It doesn't get better than that, does it? It really doesn't. Right, back to some of your messages. Have we run out of messages? I think we have. Or haven't I read them all? Sometimes I miss them, and I do apologise if I miss them. Adam says, Chris, I would like to offer the services of Adam the Plumber, Property Maintenance and Plumbing, to come and sort your background out. What's wrong with my background? There's nothing wrong with my back. What's wrong with my background? Don't you like it? Is it time for a change? It has been up there a year now. I think this is the best background I have ever. It looks lots of little Union Jacks there, you see. You like that, do you? You like that? Can I just read out a couple of messages from Joanne? Because we didn't read her message. She got very upset, poor old Joanna. Joanna, isn't it? Joanna. She got very upset because I missed her messages. I didn't miss your messages, Joanne. Sometimes we just don't get to them, darling. It's just a little bit impossible to get to some. Look, here's her scolding message to me from yesterday's show. You didn't read out my messages from Friday's show. Well, here they are coming up now, darling. She said, yes, I'm still in hospital, probably for another week. She's in hospital at the moment. And she says, everyone here is truly enjoying the show. The nurses and doctors are signing up for your programme. I've been leaving info how to get through your programme. Have a wonderful day, Joanna. So that she left that yesterday. Who's calling in now, please? Nope, no one. Okay. 169. Someone called in from 169. Do you want to try again? And you should be able to get through, okay? If not, that's okay. Rachel said on Sat Friday's show, if a patient wants to use any electronic device in the hospital, it has to be safety checked. Because we were talking on Friday about whether you can bring in a television or something now to a hospital. Because you stay in hospital. My niece has just been in hospital. She's out now, I'm pleased to say. She's getting better now. But she had to buy a television. £7.50 a day. A day. It's a lot of money, £7.50 a day, isn't it? And Joanna says they have televisions in the waiting rooms, but for patients' rooms, you have a small telly and you do have to pay $7 a day. This is in the States. As far as computers or iPads, they have to go through security. Some hospitals do not allow them because of the different scans and medical devices on the floor, such as oxygen and heart monitors. She's also talked to a specialist at the hospital who has watched my show. He told me that my camera's probably, because we had problems with the camera, but that's sorted now, so that's all right. And Joanna also wants to say congratulations to Adam the Plumber, who's managed to lose 1 stone and 6 pounds in weight in a month, and he's on the phone now. Hello to Adam the Plumber.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chris.
A very, very good afternoon to you on behalf of myself and my conglomerates.
And Katie the Cat.
And Katie the Cat, who's walking round in circles again. Ronnie said to me, Ronnie was cruel this morning. I'm offended. Would you like to know what he said? He said, because the cat's walking round in circles, could you not get like a turntable for her to walk on and connect it to a dynamo so that you could create your own electricity? That's quite a nice thing to do, wouldn't it be?
Yeah, that'd be an excellent idea, save on the old electricity bill.
It'd certainly stop her wearing out my floor, walking around in circles all the time.
Or you could connect it to a water pump connected to your water butt, which then could connect to a water tank that would fill up for your toilet. Save your water bill.
That is a good idea, because I've just had a £128 water bill. But actually, as you well know, that's not bad at all, is it?
No, it's very good. a lot of people are actually frightened of going on water meters. I don't know why, because they do save a lot of money.
Yeah, they shouldn't be. I'm on a water meter. I do water my garden in the summer, and that is the dearest it's ever been. I tell you what, though, Adam, I notice it goes up a few quid each time. It absolutely goes up about 5 quid. Every time a new bill comes on, it's about 5 quid more than it was last time. I've noticed.
That's right. I mean, well, it's basically because you're stuck with a certain water supply, unlike electric companies and other utilities. You can swap and change.
Yeah.
For instance, down the church, we use a company called Utility Warehouse.
Yeah.
And they're very good because they do the broadband, the telephone, the gas, and the electric.
Yes.
And it works out a lot cheaper than the other companies.
Yeah, yeah.
But you have to sort of compare. With the water, of course, you're stuck with Thames Water or Southern Water. Or
what am I? South East? I think I'm South East. South East.
South East Water. Yeah, there's only a few water companies out there, so of course they can do what they like because it's an necessity that you need, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
So, but I was ringing in to say about your background.
Yes, what's wrong with it?
Look at the where the clock is and look down at the bottom of the I suppose it would be to your right at the bottom of the clock.
Right.
Can you see it?
What am I looking for?
The gap, where there's
gap?
The Union Jack wallpaper runs out.
Gap?
Oh, there's a gap where you can see the wall, and there's a few creases that need ironing out.
Oh, here? Do you mean this gap here? There?
Let me have a look. Hold on. Let me just get the other.
Do you mean the little bit that's like a beige colour? There's about a 10-second delay before you'll see me pointing, I'm afraid.
Okay, yep, no, I realise that.
Is that what you mean there? A gap?
Yes, that's it.
No, it's not a gap. Just a moment, please. Thank you very much. Thank you for your apology in advance. Has it gone now?
Ooh.
Has it gone?
Hang on. I'm waiting for the delay.
I'm waiting for it to catch up
chair,
on it, yes.
Coming back onto your chair. Yes, that's it. That's got rid of it.
See? Not a gap, dear. That is my electronic shredder for all my very important documents.
Right, OK.
So, not a gap. Thank you very much.
I think with the professional free services, seeing as you're a close personal friend of Adam the Plumber...
Adam the Plumber.
We could expand your back wall.
What do you mean, expand it?
Well, put some more bits on it, your clock and a couple of shelves.
Oh, yes, I could have a few more bits up there. It's funny, actually, you know, very depending on the position of the camera, it sometimes looks crooked, doesn't it?
All right.
Like it's probably it's actually looking quite straight
at the moment.
Sometimes it looks like it's bent to one side, but it's not, and I have great difficulty getting it to line up before I push the on button.
The only thing is, I'm just wondering, would that still work if you're recording on the iPhone? Do you now the camera that I'm looking at the moment, is that the live camera that you're streaming for?
Yes, it is.
Right. So does the iPhone pick up that same volume of space behind you?
Not quite as much. No.
No. So that, I suppose you've got to sort of balance.
But it's to be honest, it's not far off. It's not far off at all. Actually, you know, they're both pretty similar now.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Because, you know, as I say, you've got that lovely new gap next to the pendulum clock.
Waiting to be filled with something beautiful. Possibly a picture of myself. I don't know yet.
Could we have a public vote on what we'd like to see there?
Well, yes. Please send in your suggestions.
I think a rotating globe.
Oh, I still want a rotating globe. I do. I have found a way. You can't actually. I've looked for one. You can't find one. It's finding one that looks reasonable. But I can do it now. What I would do is hang it from a motor, the same as I've done that, rather than have it on a... There isn't a rotor. You can buy a rotating globe. Horrendously. Hundreds of pounds.
Yeah.
Hundreds of pounds. So what I would do is just buy a normal one and just hang it. Hang it like that. But it's finding a reasonable one.
And then just have UK TV underneath. It's BBC One colour.
BBC One colour. Oh, no, because the BBC would be straight on the phone, dear. They don't like any of their bits and pieces used.
You can have UK TV underneath.
United Kingdom Talk Television.
So from the Mirrorball Studios.
I don't know about that.
See what the public say, shall we?
We'll see what they say. Send your suggestions in. But you'll have to wait because I'm gonna wrap this up now. So you'll have to wait for recording to come up before you can put a message. Or just put a message on my wall. What would you like on the wall next to the clock? Let's see what people say.
That's it.
All right.
All right, Chris, have a lovely day, and I shall speak to you very soon.
You too, Adam. Thanks for calling in, all right?
Take care.
Cheerio. Bye-bye. Bye, Adam the plumber. Nice, mate. He's such a nice person, Adam. I'll tell you that now. Let's do today's birthdays, and then we're going to finish off today, boys and girls. Happy birthday today to Anthony Michael Collishaw. Are you 44? God's sake, Tony. Happy birthday, Tony. All right, love. Stefan Kendry is 27 today. Happy birthday, Stefan. Zach Thompson. I love that name, Zach. Is 26 today. Happy birthday, Zach. Janet Sarmain is 53 today. Oh, a year behind me, Janet. Happy birthday, Janet. What's that? Wednesdays at Bed Bar? That must be an advert. We'll get rid of that one. Elisa Maria Gordon is 21 today. Michael Burnett, you look very different now, Michael. Very good look you've got at the moment with that black T-shirt and glasses on. 32 today. I used to work with Michael in the Two Brewers in Clapham. Happy birthday, Michael. Chris Ward is 43 today. And DJ extraordinaire Stefan Luke. Ah, little Stefan. Happy birthday to you, Stefan. Only 27 today. You managed to lose a load of weight as well, haven't you? So well done. It's not easy to lose weight. Happy birthday to your old gang, okay? Happy birthday, happy birthday to you. Thank you very much, boys and girls. That's it for the show today. I shall see you again very soon for another one. I never know when I'm going to do these live shows. They just pop up randomly. But somewhere on the screen, I believe you can subscribe. So that if you hit that subscribe button, I do believe, I'm not 100% sure about this, so don't take this for word. If you hit subscribe, then I think when I do a live show, you get a notification on your phone, just like a message coming up, so you know it's happening and you can join us live or watch the recording later on. Apart from that, enjoy your Saturday. It's still very cold out there. I'm going to do my dinner and I might go out for a little walk later on if I can bring myself over to brave the cold. I've already been out once to the church this morning. I don't know if I can bring myself to go out again in that cold weather. Enjoy your Sunday. Thanks so much for listening. Cheerio now.